It was International Women's Day yesterday, but it's over now. So let's discuss who gets to decide what feminism is. Is it men?
It's just coming up to 7:30. Can I trouble you? Because we're just on air.
Oh, sorry.
At the moment.
I was just actually tweeting Emma Watson because I got into a little spat with her yesterday.
He loves a spat, doesn't he, Piers Morgan? He's forever in a spat. I think what happened was that Piers Morgan is seeking to define, on Emma Watson's behalf, what the parameters of her feminism is. Now, let's declare right at the beginning, I've not been the world's greatest feminist, have I? Because I suppose there is a kind of an assumed alliance between promiscuity and disrespect towards women. And that's something that, since I've not been living that lifestyle, I can certainly understand what people mean by that. But like on the subject of feminism, my life has changed sort of radically, as I suppose a lot of men's does, when having a daughter. And so now an issue like this, perhaps how can you not look at it from a different perspective once you have an entirely new relationship in your life? I suppose the first thing I think of is feminism something that should be defined by Piers Morgan or by Emma Watson, particularly as it's sort of well within her individual freedom, regardless of her gender?
Because I got into a little spat with her yesterday about her Vanity Fair...
Oh, yeah.
...topless picture.
It's not a topless picture.
Okay, she...
It's not a topless picture. I am the voice of reason. Piers Morgan, he sits there, and I provide the balance while I'm sitting in my chair.
Piers describes this as a topless photograph. You can see she's clearly not topless. In fact, she's...
She is topless.
Everybody's topless under their clothes.
That's quite a good point there. I mean, I'm naked right now under these garments. I like that lady a lot. Everyone's topless under her clothes. Piers Morgan's had to have that explained to him.
People are categorising it as topless.
People are categorising it as topless. Like me, I'm a people and I just categorised it then. Topless. I used my categoriser. Categorised it all nice and topless.
And for guys on the outside looking in, we're trying to wrestle with modern feminism with this big debate, trying to work out what it is that women think feminism is. I don't think it helps when high-profile stars look like they want their cake and eat it.
I think part of... Well, I don't know what feminism is about, but I'm guessing that self-determination and the right to decide how your gender, your identity, your sexuality is received and expressed and what it means in relation to power, particularly male-dominated power, is probably part of it. And I don't really, the idea that structures and frameworks are put in place by men or a male-dominated media. Part of, I suppose, what feminism would be, she can say, I'm a beautiful woman, I'm a sexual woman, I'm a feminist woman, I'm an academic woman. She could say whatever she wants, hopefully free from judgment of Piers Morgan or anybody.
And my argument to Emma Watson is, well, you've got to work out whether you think it is compatible or conflicting for you to do that and be a feminist, because you can't have it both ways.
Actually, in a way, you can have it both ways, because you can't... who's determining these rules? That's the question. You can have it both ways. You can have it as many ways as you want. You can determine who you are. Who's in charge? Like, that's how power works. Who's the person that holds the barometer? Who's the person that says... You know, I'm not suggesting that Piers Morgan is an all-powerful figure, but I'm saying that the voice with which he's speaking is identifiable as the voice of hegemonic male power.
I'm not entirely sure this is the smartest use of Emma Watson's time, given she is such a vocal feminist.
She's also like an ambassador for UNICEF and stuff, and she goes like to sort of like gets involved in like really important issues. You know, she made some really interesting and I think admirable and personally exciting moves. Like, she went into education, didn't she? She's obviously a very bright human being. But she is also a movie star, fashion icon, and an autonomous human being who can do with her body, I suppose, whatever she wants. And like, there's a point where you sort of think, oh God, I can't take any more analysis of what constitutes topless anymore. Let's talk about other things that Emma Watson does.
Is this really the best image she wants out there?
With the relationship that Piers Morgan's historically had with the media, like, you know, the hacking stuff, it's curious just to see him sort of talking about privacy and people's ownership of their own anatomy from an apparently objective position.
But there's also an argument that feminists can do whatever they want, right? That women should be free to do whatever they like. I don't really agree.
What's interesting, I think, is when you have a vocal celebrity that steps outside of the mainstream media narratives of just, like, you know, get on there and promote that Disney film, because Emma Watson is sort of breaking out of her box and saying, and having opinions and views on areas that are not eliminated as the space for celebrities to have a voice, that she's being kind of subtly attacked and undermined. It's interesting to watch how that develops and how that will continue to evolve.
This freedom to do anything, what about if a woman is directly damaging women's rights, for example? Is she free to do that as a feminist? Of course not. There have to be limits, don't there, to what a feminist is free to do.
There's Piers Morgan's Parameters of Feminism. Feminism by Piers Morgan. OK, so that's one aspect, that's one angle on feminism. Let's see what Emma Watson herself says on the subject.
It just always reveals to me what a how many misconceptions and what a misunderstanding that there is of what feminism is. Feminism is about giving women choice. Feminism is not a stick with which to beat other women with. It's about freedom. It's about liberation. It's about equality. I really don't know what my tits have to do with it. It's very confusing.
Pretty articulate, that, from Emma Watson, isn't it? I suppose that's answered the question. We should have just gone straight to Emma Watson. Feminism, like identity politics, perhaps in general, is the right to determine yourself, to define yourself, and to do what you want without feeling that there's some oppressive external force deciding what you are on your behalf. That's some true news. Subscribe here if you want to, man.
A tool that is abused to fool you and to leave you scared and confused. Trews is like the news. If the news was true, I want some Trews. Let's have some Trews.